Hi, I'm Susan. Welcome to The Joy of Making Books. In this video, we're going to learn how to add a ribbon to our accordion so we have something that can hold it tie and hold it close, and that we can then open it up to view. For this book, we're going to need one accordion book that we've already made, a piece of cereal box, cracker box, postcard, something that is a heavier weight for the covers. And because the accordion has one on either side, I want to make sure it's big enough that I can have enough for two covers. And I have a piece of ribbon. I want it to be four times the height of the book, and a pair of scissors, a pencil, and a glue stick and scrap paper. There are two things that I want to think about before I start. One of them is which side of this I'm going to have showing on the cover. You can do just keep it plain, or you could have this side showing, which I tend to like to do. It gives you a little bit of pattern in the background if you glue other things to it. So whatever is going to be, I'm going to have this for my cover, so I want to make sure that this is face down. The other thing is it matters to me how the pages are set up going onto the cover. If you don't put the ribbon, it doesn't matter until you start writing on it. But in this case, I want the ribbon to be on the back, and I'm going to make the front cover first. So I like to have the folded edge on the top, and in order to make sure the front goes on that the right way, I am going to have the side with the two folds on the left and the side with the one fold on the right. And anytime I have to remember something, I don't like to have to remember. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my pencil and I'm just going to write an F on the front so I know that this is the front of the book. And now I'm ready to start gluing. So I'm going to take my scrap paper and I'm going to lift up the cover of my book, the first couple pages of my book, and I'm going to stick the scrap paper inside. I'm going to take my glue stick and I am going to go stripes in one direction, stripes in the other direction, cover the whole thing, take the scrap paper out and fold it in half so I won't stick anything else to it. Then I'm going to take this and I'm going to put it face down onto my cover paper. I'm going to smooth it and then I'm going to open it up and smooth it some more right where I put the glue. And then I am going to cut around here so that I have my cover. I'm going to do it nice and close to the edge, just a little bit bigger. If you look at any hardcover book, you'll see that the covers are always just a little bit bigger than the pages. And the reason for that is that their purpose is to protect the pages. Now, when I did it without the ribbon, I did it a little bit differently. But in this case, I am going to take the cover that I made. I am going to trace around it. And then I'm going to cut it out. What I'm going to do before, I'm going to use my pencil again. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to shift this over and I'm just going to put an arrow facing up because everything is not exactly even and I want to put the cover on so it goes in the same direction. And in order to do that, I'm just going to flip this over and turn it over. And I'm going to put an arrow facing up here too. So then the two will match. And now I'm going to take my scissors and cut this out. And again, the cover's job is to protect the pages, so we always have it just a little bit bigger. And now I'm ready for the glue. So I put my scrap paper inside. I do my stripes in one direction, my stripes in another direction. Oops, got a little glob of glue there. Take my scrap paper out and fold it in half. Now this time I want to put the ribbon on before I put the cover on. So I'm going to take my ribbon. I'm going to lay it across the pages. I'm just going to look at the bottom, make sure the two are pretty much even, don't have to be absolutely perfect. I want it right across the middle. And then I am going to take my paper, turn it the other way, and I want my arrow to be facing the same direction. And hopefully that will mean that the paper lines up, which it does pretty well. And then I'm going to smooth it down and then open it up and smooth it again. And then here's my book closed. I can take my ribbon. I can bring it around the front and I can tie it in a bow. Now, before you start working, in this case, you do need to pay attention when you start to work on your book because the ribbon is the back cover. So when you start to work, you want to set it down with the ribbon on the bottom, open it up, and then you can start, this will be your first page. I think adding the ribbon is such a sweet touch, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. Thanks for watching.